Yo,
What's up, dude?
what's going on, man? How are you?
I'm good, bro. What's your name?
Perry.
Are you the dude that wrote the Wonderworld Fest article?
No, that's one of our writers, Nate. He was there.
Oh, shout out Nate, bro. That's
Shout
sick.
out Nate. He bodied that. Yeah, man. So hyped you could get on. Thanks for hopping on with us.
No problem. To my viewers joining, I'm doing an interview right now with Sheesh Media. So shout out them. How's it going, guys?
What's up, everyone? But yeah, I mean, you just dropped your album. You just had one World Fest. I mean, you've been crushing it this year, but I'd love to just talk about the album right now. Like, what was that creative process like? Was it any different than Welcome Home or?
Basically, I just made this album in a much better headspace. I'm a guy that like kind of obsesses over, I would say, just things, especially when it comes to like work. If I'm like working on something, I don't really have like an off button unless I like force myself to have an off button. And I think this time around, just like working on music, I was like trying to get myself to go to sleep at an earlier time, just for like longevity and sustainability overall. So I think I was definitely taking better care of myself, like mentally. And I think it speaks in the music.
Yeah.
So
Yeah.
yeah, I'd say like that's the biggest difference between the two.
And how was it? I guess you were making at least some of this during quarantine. Did you have a good balance, like going out at all, or?
Yeah, I mean, quarantine sucked, especially like early 2020, I guess. But I'd just come off like a world tour, so I'd seen more things than I'd ever seen in my life. So I guess I was also riding off like the inspo from that. So like, yeah, I still had that to like kind of carry me through a little bit.
For sure. Yeah. I was actually supposed to see you in 2019 in Philly, and I couldn't
Oh,
make it,
word.
but I did see you last month in Philly, so it was worth like the 2 year wait. What
Hell yeah, that's sick.
would you say is your favorite song on the album?
Right now it's a song called Easy. It's I think track six. That's my favorite right now. But I feel like it might change.
Comments, comment your people in the comments, comment your favorite song. I'm
Hold on,
curious.
I think the chat is like frozen for me. Yeah, it definitely is. I don't know. I think it's like I hopped off my own Wi-Fi and I think they like broke the live. Are there
Damn.
people in here?
There are people. It's working
Okay.
for
All
me.
right, sick.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll take your word for it. You have to like give me, I guess, what they're saying. What are people saying?
Easy, Desperado, how rude. I imagine everyone's gonna say
Yeah, everyone's got a different favorite. That's a tall order I'm asking of you.
every time I listen to it, I have a new favorite. So it really was like no skip album.
Appreciate you, man.
How about with the album cover? Do you like draw your visuals at all? Those sketches?
Yeah. Hold on. Let me grab my sketchbook.
Dope.
I love showing people this. So like, bro, so from like the beginning of me making this album, I just started fucking drawing shit in here. I'll find like the actual album cover here. It's right here. Is this guy?
That's dope.
So,
Work.
basically everything from this album I've drawn, and it's all in that notebook. So I basically, yeah, I kind of just try to make that my, I guess, aesthetic this time around. And I've always drawn ever since I was like really young, so it's like second nature to me. But yeah, just tried to like force that kind of aesthetic evolution, because I don't want to be doing the same shit all the time. And for the next album, it's probably going to be something different. So,
For sure. And it feel like it makes your whole project more cohesive that you're thinking of the visuals as you're making the music and vice versa, I'm sure. And you incorporate the sun a lot on this album, obviously. Is there like of significance to the sun with this project?
The significance of the sun, I mean, I've always been kind of talking about the sun. And I think that comes from like when I first started making music, I was very anxious. I was like a homebody and very reclusive. I was dealing with a lot of like anxiety at the time and just like kind of scared to even go outside or to a friend's house, like thinking I'd have a panic attack. So the sun was like, to the sun to me, like metaphorically, this is like about to get real cheesy, but it's like real as fuck to me. Was like me in my bedroom making songs, like never going outside, and the sun was like a goal. Like let me get outside. That like the sun is my understanding of like, I guess just like working hard here so I can make it out, you know. So sounds corny, but to me it like means a lot that it's like full circle that I started out like really thinking like that. And this whole arc is like the album name in and of itself, like the whole album name that's not the actual name on like DSPs is Believe in Me, Who Believes in You, Journey to the Sun, like colon, Journey to the Sun. So not saying that I've like completed my journey to the sun, I would say, you know, like I feel like we could all get healthier in our own lives. Sorry if I'm rambling right now, by the way, but yeah.
Awesome. And I don't know if you can still can't see the chat, but a lot of people are asking about Wasted Love. They're begging me to ask you about that.
Man, all right. I'm gonna get that figured out, right? That was supposed to be on the album. I can't see the chat, and I know they're probably gonna be like, why? I literally can't speak on it, but I'm gonna figure out something. I'm gonna figure out something for you guys.
There you go. So I saw you first started teasing a demo of Kids on Molly back in 2017. And then apparently you teased ETA on your Welcome Home tour in 2019.
Yeah.
I was wondering, like, were there other songs on the album that you had kind of started a while ago and you were sitting on, or?
Yeah, dude. So like through 2020, I made a bunch of songs, and there was like there's the SoundCloud playlist I had at the time. It's not up anymore. It was like a private one. That had like it was like close to 50 songs on there that were all contenders like for an album. So like songs that I like genuinely like, I'm like, okay, these are fucking really good. And like I was trying to dial it down to 10 originally. I ended up making it 12. But yeah, for sure. There's songs that are very old that I would still put them out if they don't like if they, as long as they make sense in the context of like a project. And excuse me. I had Mexican food earlier. I'm fucking burping. And as long as they don't sound like too dated, you know.
For sure. And I guess that kind of goes into my next point. Like, so apparently you had Believe in Me, Who Believes in You, that title for 2 years too, right?
Yeah.
So do you kind of think far out with your albums? Like, are you already kind of thinking about, the next one and have some of that music?
Yeah, yeah. I have low key, I have like another album name in my head. I don't tell anyone though. Like even when I had the album title, I told everyone I had it, and it's funny because I like sent this SoundCloud playlist that I was telling you about with like the contenders on there. I've been sending it for like 2 years ago or whatever, and it was the album title, but all the each letter was an asterisk, so it was like fill in the blank. And my friends would always be like, "What the fuck is this long ass title, bro?" I never told them. And yeah, I have like titles in my head that like make sense with at least like the songs that I already have. But I'm gonna take a little break from music, just not like a big one, like literally like a week or two, just for my own sanity, and then get back and see like what makes sense going forward. I plan to keep releasing shit, so.
Oh yeah, and you have a, big tour coming up too in a couple months, so gotta
Yeah, I gotta get ready for that. Gotta get in shape.
do you ever go back and like reflect on old songs like Mr. Fantastic and Limelight, which were maybe 5 years ago at this point?
Yeah.
Those?
For sure, yeah. I mean, those songs are, I still think those are good songs. I'm surprised you even know about those. Those are like the first uploads on my YouTube, by the way, for anyone in the chat. The chat is still frozen for me, by the way.
Oh,
I just see a comment that says, Aries saved my cat from a burning tree, and it's just been there.
So I'll have to tap into it.
Yeah. But yeah, what was your question?
Oh, just like if you listen to, you know, some of your older songs.
Yeah, sometimes I go back. For sure. Not often, though.
Word. Someone asked, or I guess a few people asked about Under the Skin. Was it Under the Skin? Yeah.
I'm not going to answer any more questions about snippets. Yeah. Wasted Love was the only one. I just felt obligated because that was supposed to be on the project. But maybe, that's all I'm going to say.
Deluxe version or something. But I noticed you haven't done any really collaborations with other artists, other than, you know, working with producers and songwriters, but do you plan to do any sort of collaboration in the future and any artists that you'd want to do a collab with?
That's another thing I'm not going to speak too much on. I got some things coming up. But yeah, cause I have never done that. But I guess publicly, but I'm working on stuff like that for sure.
And then, yeah, let's talk about Wonderworld Fest. I mean, I wish I could have went to that, but how was that, like, being in your hometown, and what was kind of like the highlight of that show?
Man, the highlight was the whole night for me. I swear, if there was like a security camera just like watching me backstage, because, like, I mean, obviously I wasn't in the crowd for every artist set, but I watched every artist set. Just like, it was fun, bro. Like, just from behind the curtain, I was just by myself, just turning up. Wasn't on my phone, you know, just living in the moment. It's everything I wanted to do. I've always been very into, like, the live show. And I think it was only right that, you know, put together a Wonderworld Fest. You know, we're trying to do it every year and expand and grow. And I don't ever want to make it, like, too corporate where, like, you know, the artists just fucking go to their green room and, like, I want to bring everyone together type shit, you know? Like, the vibe of that night was just, like, every artist that was there, I had, like, an amazing conversation with, you know? And it was, like, my first time meeting most of them. And, yeah, it was just, it was a highlight of, like, my life, honestly.
That's awesome. And then you have your tour coming up next year. Where are you, like, most excited to play, would you say?
Man, I'm excited for the whole tour, honestly. But, man, the Europe dates last time around, they're just, like, crazier, I feel like, because they don't get American artists that often. Like, I'm very excited for London.
Shout out London.
It's also the biggest show that I'm playing, so, yeah. I mean, I'm excited for every date. I'm not gonna write off the U.S. Like, the U.S. is definitely some crazy crowds, but I mean, my show is like full of energy, and I bring energy and charisma every time I perform. And I'm very excited. Like I said, though, I gotta get in shape. it's gonna be a long run, but yeah, just to give it my all, you know.
What kind of workout routine are you into?
Shit, bro, like, anything. I haven't even started, but I know I got to, because I don't work out. Like, I play basketball here and there, but that's not enough. I gotta get something going. I gotta join a spin class or something.
Hoops is great for cardio.
Yeah, for sure.
I guess, I mean, probably Wonderworld Fest, but maybe prior to that, do you have like a favorite memory from just like any tour or show?
I mean, my favorite shows were probably my San Diego show prior to Wonderworld Fest and my last London show, just because of, like, the crowds. And it's funny because, like, certain, like, sometimes there'll be a huge crowd, but that doesn't necessarily translate to, like, them being nuts, you know? Like,
yeah.
Sometimes it's, like, the way that the room – I feel like you can't really understand this unless, like, you're an artist that's, like, played in a certain room, because, like, I've heard this kind of shit before where, like, the room itself has a certain energy, you know? Like, there's certain rooms, like the way they're built, like they're able to give more. It's weird. It's really weird, but it made sense to me after, like, I played some shows that were like just more, I guess, more people there, like whatever. And then I'm like, oh, whoa, this smaller show just felt like so much more fun. And it's like, it's the room, dude. Like, sometimes, like, the room, like, has this energy. I don't know. I don't know how to explain
No,
it, but
definitely.
yeah.
Can you hear me okay still?
Yeah. Am I lagging out right now?
For a second, but you're good now. Yeah, even at the Philly show last month, like you could just tell you had complete command. Like you would tell these kids, you go like that side of the room, go there, left side, go there, and just they would listen to anything you said, which I don't know. The energy was just unreal.
Yeah, for sure.
But yeah, how's your cat doing? And did you give your cat a name? Yeah.
He's doing good. I got him on a diet right now, because he's a pretty fat motherfucker, honestly. And no, he doesn't have a name, but he's doing good. He's doing all right. He's probably
Good.
asleep, so I'm not gonna bug him right now.
For sure.
But
They sleep all day. I have two cats.
yeah, I love cats.
I don't know if you saw, we did some memes from your story.
I think I did. I think I did see them.
What'd you think of those?
I can't remember what the memes were off the top of my head, but I'll have to check them out after this.
Word. So when you're not making music, like what's your favorite thing to do to kind of take a break?
Shit, man. I mean, I've been wanting to play some video games, honestly. I don't really do anything besides music, though. I like to just do that, make music, be creative. All the creative stuff, that's like my cup of tea.
Yeah,
Sounds like
for
I have no life, but I mean, that is like my life.
yeah, I mean, I feel like you're probably most happy in your element making music, so that makes sense. Someone said Aries Cat's perfect shaped. I thought that was notable to tell you.
Thank you. Chat's still frozen for me, by the way. So these are I'm counting on you, Barry.
I wish you could see these. Let's see, but yeah, what's some advice you'd give just kind of up and coming producers or even artists?
Up and coming producers and artists, I would say, if you're young, you can afford to put all your eggs in one basket. And if you are really passionate about like making music, you should go for it, as long as like you're really, really passionate about it. And if you're a little older, then I wouldn't put all your eggs in one basket, because you got to play the game of life a little bit. You gotta probably get it like a day job, but also like still do the music, you know? Like, don't, when you get home after work, like, don't just fucking wind down, like get to work, you know, because you can still make the shit happen. And yeah, I guess that's my advice right there. That's some like life advice if you're trying to follow your dreams.
No, absolutely. I mean that, yeah, that applies to kind of anyone, any job.
Yeah.
One lyric I wanted to ask you
You're
about.
gonna die one day. You might as well
Everyone,
follow your dreams, man. You might as well, because you don't want to live unhappy. Go ahead, though. Sorry to cut you off. I just had to say that.
you're good. I was just gonna ask about this one lyric, the JFK one from One Punch. Like, how did that come about? Or what inspired
What
that?
is the lyric? He took a shot for the magazines. Yeah,
Never
I
ride
took a
in
shot.
the lane.
It's just a playoff, like another shot, John Kennedy, like. This person I'm talking about took a shot for the magazines, like she's taking pictures, and then another shot, John Kennedy, is like, could be alcohol, you know, but also like John Kennedy got murked,
Right.
so
He did.
it's
Rest in.
kind of just a play. No disrespect to JFK, bro.
Absolutely. Yeah, and then if you could pick one person dead or alive that you'd have lunch with, like it could be anybody, would you pick?
Have lunch with. You seen those memes of like, would you take the dinner with Jay-Z or take like $500,000 or whatever?
Yeah,
that shit's so funny. That being said, I don't know, and I don't know if it would be Jay-Z, because I would take $500,000 over a dinner with Jay-Z,
especially if you invest that.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. No, I don't know though. I don't know. Maybe Akon. I'll go have a dinner with Akon. Yeah,
that's a classic. Akon.
He's a mogul.
He's a mogul. I think he has his own cryptocurrency, or he's trying to build his own city, like.
Yeah, yeah, in Africa, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's doing big shit. Shout out Akon.
Who are some artists that you listen to?
Dude, I don't really like listen to too much like new music like that, honestly. Like sometimes it stresses me out. I think I'm gonna slowly get back into it, but just like during this album phase, I feel like I was definitely like kind of avoiding, not on purpose, but just like I don't really listen to too much new shit. Like I used to a lot when I was in high school and stuff. Like I always had a headphone in, or ear pod or whatever. What the fuck are they called? The headphone. AirPod. Yeah, just like the stringy one, not overhead. You know.
Yeah, like earbud.
Yeah, yeah, earbud. I always have one of those in. And like, yeah, that was my vibe. But yeah, I don't really listen to too much new shit. I always go back and listen to like heavy stuff, like the stuff I grew up on, like System of a Down or like Linkin Park and stuff. I was supposed to go to a System of a Down concert like a couple weeks ago, but the lead singer Serge got fucking COVID, dude. I was like,
brutal.
So excited for it too.
Damn.
Yeah, but yeah, that's my answer.
I mean, I hear it in the, you know, because your music has a lot of different kind of genre influences, so that's cool. I was curious, but someone asked a really specific question, because you have a lot of Dragon Ball Z references in your songs, and they asked if you ever played Dragon Ball FighterZ.
Dude, yeah, I'll smoke you in Dragon Ball FighterZ. Who said that?
Shout out Ben Newkirk.
Ben Newkirk, come get it, bro. I actually, low-key, I haven't played that game in a couple months, but I got really damn good at it for a sec.
What are some you played?
I mained with Roshi, by the way. Roshi was like my main. But go ahead.
But what were some like other games you play? Someone else asked them.
My like all-time faves, I would have to put like Super Mario Sunshine, The Binding of Isaac, like the OG Pokemon game, like Diamond and like Sapphire vibe. And honestly, like any kind of Dragon Ball Z game, I'm kind of cool with. I just like have a bias towards anything Dragon Ball related. So always growing up playing that shit.
The one
punch. And like Halo, like I play Halo. I'm not like too into like the like shooter games, but Halo is sick.
Halo's dope. Oh man, the chat's going crazy.
Damn, bro. Wait, should I like hop out real quick and hop back in and see if it works?
Like, or
is it not worth it? I guess our time's almost up.
I'll do a quick scroll here.
Is this gonna be like live afterwards on your page?
I don't think so. I can try and save it.
No, it's totally up to you. I've only seen this one comment this whole time.
That's crazy. Someone said explain bad news.
Explain it?
I don't know. I don't know what that means. I mean, I guess lyrically, or I don't know. We'll skip that one. Ask about Easy. I already asked about his favorite song. Like, moving too fast for me to to properly read these. Here's one. How did the collab with Cody Ko and Noel Miller come about for Bad News?
Dude, I don't even remember. I don't remember, like, I think I just messaged them after I was on Cody's podcast like a long time ago. Oh, the chat's working for me now.
Is it
Let's
working?
go. It
Bye.
works, I think. Wait, I'm gonna type something. Yeah, I think. Yeah, there we go. It works. Cool. With like the last 2 minutes of me supposed to be on. But yeah, I don't really remember too much about that. But they're the homies, man. Shout out Cody and Noel.
And you have vinyls, merch, a lot of questions there.
What's
Do you
that?
have any vinyl version coming out? And people are asking about it.
Eventually, yeah, we're working on that. We
Okay.
are working on that.
Word, man. Well, really appreciate you hopping on. Big supporters here at Sheesh and hype for your upcoming tour and everything. New music.
Appreciate all you guys, man. Seriously.
Oh yeah. Awesome. Well, enjoy the
Good
rest of your
talk.
great chatting.
Love, dude. Peace.